Hello friends, my name is Wasim and I welcome you all to this channel Smart Study. So friends, in this video I am going to discuss an interesting day-based puzzle which is having two parameters, and this is once again an important question from the point of view of any bank examination. So friends, when you come across the question, try to solve the question by yourself, then continue watching the video. So without wasting much time, let's go ahead. As you can see, the question here is J, K, L, M, N and O are six children of Miss Shreya. Each of the children was born on different days of the week except Sunday. So see here friends, there are six children to Mr. Shreya, that is J, K, L, M, N and O, and these six children were born on different days of the week except Sunday. So those six children were born on six different days. So but it is not Sunday. The days would not include Sunday. Since we already know that there are seven days in the week, so out of those 7 days, Sunday will be eliminated. So therefore there are 6 days from Monday. So let me put it here: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So we are not going to put Sunday here, since there is no, Sunday will not be included here. Miss Shreya gave birth to a child every alternate year. So Shreya is giving the birth to every child every alternate year. Every alternate year means what? So year after 1 year there will be a gap, then after that she is going to give another childbirth. So for example, Shreya is going to give birth to a child in the year 2010, then the next child would be 2011. It will not be 2011, it will be 2012. So alternate year means, so 1 year gap will be there. After that she is going to deliver another baby. So let's say she has delivered a baby in the year 2010, then she is not going to deliver in the year 2011, she will be delivering in the year 2012, but not necessarily in the same order as names of the children are given. That's fine. Each child teaches a different subject. So each of these six children are going to teach different subjects. The subjects are Hindi, Biology, Physics, English, Mathematics and Accounts, but not necessarily in the same order. So what we have to do here, we need to arrange the children of Shreya in which year they have got birth, and on which of these 6 days they have got birth, and which of these six children they are going, which of these six subjects they are going to teach. So let us go one by one. Let me change the ink here so that it should not get confused. I am going to put the days as the basis here. So based on that we have to solve. M was born on Tuesday. So M was born on Tuesday. It's a very direct statement. M was born on Tuesday, but not before 2010. It means M was born after 2010. So M was born after, this person who has got birth on Tuesday, or M has got birth after 2010. And he teaches Hindi. So this M is going to teach Hindi. This is once again a direct statement. Whereas L teaches mathematics. So this is one more information, but we don't know on which of these 6 days L is going to teach mathematics. So let me put it here. So L is going to teach maths here. This is one more information. I repeat, M was born on Tuesday. M was born on Tuesday, but not before 2010. It means M is going to get birth after 2010. So M will be after 2010, and he teaches Hindi. So M is going to teach Hindi. So whereas L teaches mathematics, L is going to teach mathematics, but we are not sure on which of these 6 days he has got birth. So I have just put it on hold. The next one is the child who was born on Wednesday teaches biology. So the child who has got birth on Wednesday is going to teach biology. So biology he will be teaching. The person who has got birth on Wednesday is going to teach biology. The next one is the fourth eldest child teaches English. So fourth eldest child. So fourth eldest is going to teach English. So we cannot put this. We are not sure who is fourth eldest and on which of these 6 days has got birth. So that is why I am just putting on hold. While K teaches accounts. So the fourth eldest will be teaching English and K will be teaching accounts. So let me put it over here. K teaches accounts. So K is going to teach accounts. So accounts, key accounts can be here. So there are four possibilities, so I have to keep it on hold. The next one is J, who was born in 2005, teaches physics. So, but again, it is not mentioned on which of these 6 days he has got birth. So I have to put it on hold here as well. So J, who has got birth in the year 2005, is going to teach physics. He's going to teach physics. Okay, but we don't know where J and 2005 and where physics is. So I have to keep it on hold once again. The next one is mathematics is studied by the third eldest child. So mathematics is studied by the third eldest child. We already know that the third, L is going to teach mathematics. So therefore, he will be third eldest. I repeat. So mathematics is studied by the third eldest child. So we already know that L is going to teach mathematics. So L will be the third eldest. But again, it is going to form more possibilities. But then see here, friends. Third eldest child was born on Friday. Mathematics is studied by third eldest child was born on Friday. So therefore, Friday is here. So we already know that L is going to teach mathematics. So therefore, I'm going to put L here and mathematics would be at this place. But again, see here, friends, he will be third eldest. So this person would be third eldest. Okay, this is also done. Okay, the next one is K was born on Thursday. So K was born on Thursday. Thursday is here. So K was born on Thursday. We already know that K is going to teach accounts. So therefore, accounts has to be substituted here. So this is also done. Okay, and O was on Saturday. So I repeat, K was born on Thursday and O was born on Saturday. So Saturday is here. Who has to be placed here, and we are not sure about the subjects, so let us keep it on hold. So see here, friends, J, who has got birth in 2005, is going to teach physics. So J is going to teach physics. So only this place we can put J here. Why? Because so we have to put J as well as physics here. So that's therefore I'm going to put J here as well as physics at this place, and only one person is left out, only one subject is left out. Which of those persons and subjects, let's check out. So person is J, K, L, M, N is not done. So N has to be placed here. The same manner, subjects are Hindi, Biology, Physics, English. English is also done, I guess. Sorry, English is not done. So English has to be placed here. English is not placed anywhere, right? So we already know that fourth eldest would be English. So this person has to be fourth eldest. Okay. So J is got birth in the year 2005. So 2005 has to be placed here. The next one is J is the eldest child. So it is said what? J is the eldest child. So J is the eldest child. So he will be the eldest. In the sense, he is the first person who has got birth to Miss Shreya. So therefore, he will be the eldest. So N is the youngest. While N is the youngest. So N would be the youngest. So this person would be the youngest. So see here, friends. So this is third eldest. So now we have to put the years. So we already know that it is said what? Miss Shreya gave birth to a child every alternate year. Every alternate year means if the eldest child has got birth in the year 2005, then the second eldest would have got birth in the year, so 2007. So see here, friends, we cannot put 2007 here. Why? Because so this person M has got birth in the after 2010. So therefore we cannot put 2007 here. Again, we cannot put 2007 here as well. Why? Because so this person is the youngest person. In the sense, he has got birth at last. So therefore we cannot put 2007 for this person. So this is third eldest, this is fourth eldest. Then I can certainly say that this person, that is K, has got, is the second eldest. So therefore second eldest is 2007. So third eldest, so see here, friends. So I'm going to put the years here: 2005, 2007, 2009, 2011, then 2010 will not be there, 2013, then 2015. So here friends, third eldest would be, so first eldest would be 2005, second eldest would be 2007, third eldest would be 2009. So this person has to be 2009. Then fourth eldest would be 2011. So therefore fourth eldest would be 2011. Then this person has got birth after 2010. So therefore I can certainly say that this person is 2013 and this person is the youngest. So since it is, this person is the youngest, I have to put 2015 for this person. So therefore 2015 has to be placed here. I hope you got the point. I repeat, since every alternate year means the eldest would be the eldest would be 2005, then second eldest would be immediately after 1 year gap he will get birth. So therefore, see here friends, so it is said after 2010, so therefore he cannot be the youngest, so we have to put 2007, right? So therefore this person has got birth after 2010, we cannot consider this, so this person is the youngest. So n is the youngest, so therefore we cannot put 2007. So this is third eldest, this is fourth eldest. Then I can certainly say that this is 2007, this would be 2009, and this would be 2011. Then after that 2013 is this person, youngest would be 2015. So see here friends, arrangement is not so difficult, only thing is you have to practice well. So this is all I can say, practice well, do well in the actual exam. So I will not take much of your time, I will end up the session here. But again, as usual, I'm going to say, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, share the video with your friends, and if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment box. And do not forget to join our Telegram channel as well as like us on Facebook. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day ahead.